In today's OpenToonz tutorial, I'll be showing you two ways to export your animation into a video. But first, let's do some finishing touches to the animation we did in the previous video. Also, no, I'm not slapping my head into the laptop again. My head hurts. I'm just gonna snap my fingers like this.
Alright, we're back in OpenToonz and I'm fine with the animation. However, we're just gonna add a background, which I did off screen. So simply click and drag this onto the canvas and select import or load, whichever you prefer. For this one, I'm selecting load. Rearrange the columns by dragging the column name so that the background is behind the subject. You know, now that I think about it, I'm gonna make this slightly larger so I can pan the camera around. So let's select animate tool. And on the subtool, we'll be selecting scale. And then we're gonna click and drag so that the background is in the right size that we prefer. Let's select the camera column, right click on frame 20 and select set key. Next, we're gonna right click on frame 40, right click and select set key again. And then let's select the animate tool and select position, and we're just gonna nudge the camera a bit to the right. Now when we play this, the camera pans a bit as they jump. Before we import sounds, we need to download an extra plugin in order to be able to import MP3 files. This will also be important when we export our animation into a video later on. This plugin is called FFmpeg and I will put the download link in the description down below. On the download side, you can select whatever version that is compatible on your computer. Mine is Windows 10 64-bit, so let's select the Windows builds by BTBN and you can select the compatible version there. I'm selecting this Win64GP and it will be downloaded. Once it's downloaded, extract it and move it to the folder onto the OpenToonz folder just so we know where it is for the next step. So now we're going back to OpenToonz. Let's click File and Preferences. A window will pop out and on the side, let's select Import/Export. And if you check here, it says FFmpeg Path. Click the dots and find the folder where you put the extracted file earlier. That's why I said to move it to the OpenToonz folder. Select the FFmpeg folder. Select bin and then click choose. While you're at it, you can also select where OpenToonz will save the rendered video. So click on this dot over here and feel free to select your preferred file location. Now we can import some files in the same way as you do with an image and it's gonna show up in the action. I want to align this when the character jumps because it's a sound effect. So let's just drag the little black bar on the left side and position it right around here. Let's play to see what it looks like. Alright, let's go and import this. The first way to export and my favorite way to export is through an image sequence. This is ideal if you're doing post-production and you're going to import it into a video editing software like Adobe Premiere. In order to export, we're going to click render in the menu and a window will pop out with the settings. Everything is fine but I'm just gonna change one setting and that is the file type. I want this to be PNG. By default, it's set on TIFF but I prefer PNG because it's more universally used. So once you've done that, just click render on the bottom of the window and just wait for a bit and you can tell it's done if OpenToonz showed a preview. So where can we find the image? So open up OpenToonz folder on the Explorer. If you created a project, you can select the project folder and select the project name you've chosen and it will be in the outputs folder. If it's not there, chances are it's in the sandbox. So back on the OpenToonz folder, select sandbox and select outputs and you can find the images there. The second method is rendering it into an MP4 video. This method includes the sounds on export unlike in image sequence where there's no sound. Let's go back to the menu and select render and to render it as an MP4 video, select fast render to MP4. Once it's done rendering, you can find it in the location you selected earlier in the preferences. And there you have it! We have finished an animation and rendered it into a video. Give yourself a nice clap for finishing this tutorial series. It is very basic but it should be enough for you to be able to create an animated short or whatever animation you desire.
If you have any questions, leave it in the comments down below. And if you want to watch more tutorials, you can check this video on the right.